Rim lighting in a light motion. Rim lighting refers to backlighting, a lighting technique where the light is positioned behind the character, illuminating the edges and contours. You can have your rim light stay where you place it, or you can have it move around too. Now we're going to learn how to do it in a light motion. Creating the rim light. Firstly, get your character. Duplicate it twice. Then take the layer that is at the top and position it using location. Afterwards, select the two layers at the top by tapping and holding on the layer thumb and pick exclusion group. Now you can change the color of the lighting by going into color and fill. You can also add a blending mode if you'd like. If you were to enter the group through edit group, know that this visible part is the light. You can adjust the topmost layer to adjust the visible part, in other words, the light. Animating the rim light. Once you're inside the group, you can take the topmost layer and add keyframes to animate the light. Note, you need 2 keyframes for an animation to occur. That is 2 at least, okay? Then move, angle, and adjust as you wish. When you exit the group, the rim lighting will show up nicely animated. Rim lighting shadow. To add a shadow over the character, there are multiple ways. You can go to effects, then add the effects from the color and light category, specifically these effects. One of my favorites is gradient overlay. I can just add it and change the blending mode. Both of the colors in the gradient are also adjustable. If you have a group of the character, you can select the layers and pick group to put them in a group. Then you can go to color and fill, set the color and lower the opacity of the color and it'll do. But this will not work for an image, only groups. Another way is to duplicate the character, group it, and then set a color from color and fill. Go to blending and opacity and choose a blending mode. Adjust the opacity if needed. Make sure the rim light group is at the top of all the layers. Inner blurring of the rim light. You can have the inner edges of the rim light be blurry by heading inside the group and then by adding the Gaussian blur effect onto the topmost layer. Tips. You can have the rim light be the color of the light that is coming from behind, and you can have the color of the shadow be the same color as the color of the environment. This will allow the character to blend in with the scene while also maintaining a feel that they are the subject. And I'd suggest you to apply this lighting only after finishing the animation, as it can get pretty laggy. Just know that there is only one setting holding it all together. That is the exclude blending mode on the topmost layer, which was added when we picked exclusion group. Have a nice day!